Welcome, everyone. Thank you for coming tonight. My name is Christine Mecklenburg, and I am a senior QA automation engineer on the payments team, which is one of the many money teams here at Indeed. We've got several teams spread across three cities that support our financial applications at Indeed. As an automation engineer, I'm responsible for writing automated regression tests against both our front-end and back-end applications that make up our financial systems. I'm here to talk to you about how we have worked to increase our automated test coverage so that our teams as a whole can move faster. So first, I'll tell you a little bit of background about the money teams and about our culture on our teams. And then I'll discuss some of the problems that we ran into when we were looking at expanding our automated test coverage. And then discuss some of the solutions that we collaborated with each other on and came up with to increase our test coverage and some of the key results that came out of it. So a little bit of background first. I am on the payments team. It's one of the money teams here in Austin. We also have teams in Seattle and Hyderabad. And we are responsible for creating business critical applications. These are deployables that are involved in invoicing, charging our customers for their usage of our products, issuing refunds if necessary, things of that nature. And because these applications are so business critical, it is absolutely essential that we enforce rigorous QA practices. Customers depend on us to safeguard their financial information, and thorough QA work takes time. If you break financial systems, you're going to have a bad time. We also have very collaborative teams. We all work together to ensure that we're putting out quality products at a reasonable pace. If you've been in software development for very long, you might have experienced teams that throw things over the wall from development to QA, where these development and QA are siloed, don't really talk to each other very much. And while things are being QA'd, the developer moves on to another feature and kind of forgets about what they were working on before. So if it comes back, it's context switching, takes a lot of time. That's not really the case on the money teams. We work together, devs, software engineers, QA folks, program managers, product managers, we're all working together to ensure that we're putting out quality products. Manual QA work is necessary on our teams, but it's also time consuming. Automated regression testing can provide the same or even better coverage and free up manual QA engineers to do exploratory or edge case testing. And it's a lot more fun if they're not having to spend a bunch of time doing this rote, repetitive testing. But we ran into some problems. When I started at Indeed in November of 2017, money teams only had partial coverage for two deployables. We had 33 API tests, which covered one of 11 endpoints on that one deployable, and only represented 5% of our current coverage, automated test coverage. And we had just 10 UI tests representing partial coverage of 2 of 23 pages or components. And that represents just 2% of what our coverage is today on that deployable. So it wasn't a great place for us to be in. And QA was slow as a result. And there's some ongoing concerns as well that still exist today. One is that feature work can outpace automation. As financial teams, we are often subject to external deadlines, financial mandates that pop up that other countries are coming up with. So we can't just say, wait, hold on, we need a few more months to implement this new feature. It's a strict deadline. So that's the situation we find ourselves in sometimes. We can't just stop and wait for automation to catch up. Additionally, most teams at Indeed and within the money umbrella don't have a dedicated automation engineer. So we have teams where software engineers are responsible for writing automation, or where automation engineers are sharing their expertise across multiple teams. So we brainstormed. How can we increase test coverage and move faster? We came up with some social innovations. Now, these solutions that I'm going to discuss are not mutually exclusive. teams mix and match depending on what works for them. One of the great things about Indeed is our culture is not prescriptive. We give teams the autonomy to determine what their workflow looks like and what various strategies work for them. So one of the solutions that I implemented on my team, or two teams actually, that I was supporting, was getting developers involved in writing tests in our existing test framework. So we have one test framework that's written in Python using PyTest as our test runner, and we had built out a bunch of test suites in this framework. We wanted to get developers more involved in writing tests, so I started creating small, well-defined tickets that they could contribute to. These were things like maintenance tickets, so page locator changes on the web app that could go in and fix the page object model in the repository, or an error message changes in a response on an API, or discrete new tests for new functionality or changed functionality. So small bite-sized pieces that were easy for developers to jump in and contribute to. During this, I also gave hands-on support for repository setup. In most cases, this was a new repository that they hadn't worked with before, they weren't familiar with, so I helped them navigate it, helped them set it up, helped them do their Python and PyTest setup, and also critically provided timely code reviews so that they got timely feedback, thorough feedback, so that they got more comfortable and were putting out good test code. This is feedback from one of the software engineers on my team working on Shield tests, Shield being the name of this common repository. Helps keep our testing suite up to date with the latest feature changes. It helps the dev who built the feature has the context required to write an in-depth test. Another strategy that some teams have implemented is test-driven development, where they're explicitly writing tests before they do the feature work. They include integration tests as part of the definition of done. So tests, feature, done. This is feedback from one of the QAs, whose team's team does this exclusively. Having SWEs and QAEs, that's our manual QAs, writing automated tests upfront for our products that provided the basis for an automated regression suite, and has freed up my time to be more involved in initial test design with the team. Having that living automated regression suite has greatly increased our team's confidence in the quality of our releases. And then a third strategy that several teams have implemented, often in parallel with test-driven development, is pair or mob programming. So this is working on automation either in parallel with feature work or afterwards. In parallel would be typically this test-driven development approach. Pair and mob programming, whether it's in the context of automated regression testing or not, provides shared ownership over decisions and extensive knowledge sharing. So when I'm in a mob programming session, I'm learning new things about the language or the IDE or commands on the command line even, and the developers that I'm working with are learning more about test strategy and how to write good, concise tests. This is feedback from one of the software engineers. Their team exclusively does mob programming. They've actually have it as a rule on their team that they won't do any individual coding. They're just doing mobbing now. Having the automation as part of our mob coding process brings the automation to our team at the time of completion, or time of implementation, sorry, versus feeling as an afterthought and a separate work item. All mob members are involved in the automation process, and we see how new requirements break things. Mob coding iterations show how the requirements are being implemented and they're working properly in the integrated automated tests. So, where are we today? We now have almost 500 UI tests, and 48 times the number we had a little over 2 years ago. We have almost 1,900 API tests, which is 57 times as many as we had 2 years ago. We now have automation coverage for 24 deployables and counting. And some specific examples. This is a test suite, I'll nickname D. It now has 655 tests. This is an API test suite. It saves at least 2 days of nonstop, doing nothing else, manual QA work. And we do about one deploy a month of this deployable. That saves 24 work days of manual QA time a year. Additionally, with this particular test suite, during a crunch time to meet a financial mandate recently, this test suite found multiple bugs with a third-party system, bugs that would have affected not just us, but hundreds, if not thousands, of customers of this third-party system across the globe. Test suite E has 133 tests. This is another API test suite. It saves about 1 day of solid manual QA time per iteration, and has about 3 deploys per month. That's 36 days of manual QA time saved a year with this one test suite. So these are 2 examples of the 24 test suites that we have today. And all of that helps us, helps our teams move faster overall. Any questions?
All right, everybody. That's Christine Mecklenburg. Let's give her a round of applause.